A Safehell nonprofit is helping end book famine in Africa. Books for Africa sent more than 2 million education and law books to 22 countries over the past year, and the mission is ongoing. Joining us this morning with more on this great milestone for Books for Africa is Executive Director Pat Plonsky. Welcome here this morning.
Thank you.
So you guys have been around since 1988. Is
Yes.
this the first time you've reached this milestone?
It is, yes. This is a new achievement to have sent over 2 million books to 22 African countries.
So how do you gather these books, and then how do you send them and distribute them over in Africa?
Well, the books that we get are all donated, and they're donated by private citizens, schools, libraries, and universities. Also, there's companies that buy and sell books, so you add it all up and it ends up being more than 2 million books.
And you're calling it a book famine, but really we're talking about illiteracy. So based on what you're seeing now, are you seeing literacy, are you seeing benefits in these African children able to read since the organization started back in the 80s?
We are, and you know, it's a multi-tiered effort. I can't claim all the credit with Books for Africa because, you know, there's other factors as well. But we are noticing that there are more books in Africa now than there were in 1988. And, you know, it's nice when we go to Africa to see the benefits of our work. We see schools that have books that didn't have them previously. So every little bit helps. It's a large goal, and the needs are still quite substantial in Africa.
Now, books are extremely heavy. How do you ship them from the U.S. to Africa?
We actually send them in 40-foot ocean-going sea containers. That's like a semi-trailer truck. So it's every shipment is 20 tons of books, and we have forklifts. When I started at Books for Africa, we didn't, and so it's we've come a long way.
Now, you've been over there, you said, dozens of times. When you see the books distributed to the kids, what's that like? What are the kids like when they receive these free books?
Well, they're very excited, to be sure. You know, it's an interesting thing, you know, if I were to walk into a school in the United States and see everyone excited about getting books, I would say, what's going on here? But in Africa, there's usually a big party. There's singing, there's dancing, and there's celebrations and speeches. And so it's a very exciting thing. And what I like to do is I pull out the books and see where they're from. And oftentimes they're from Minnesota, although we do collect across the continent. So they might be from Canada or anywhere in the United States.
Celebrating their education. Very neat.
Absolutely.
And how did you reach the milestone this year? 2.2 million books. Was there a campaign, or were people just more generous this year?
That's just part of our ongoing effort. Due to the needs in Africa, our goal is always to send 15% more books than the previous year. And so as time goes on, we've reached some substantial quantities. And we work with large partners and also small partners. So some of those shipments were Rotary clubs and churches and private citizens. Others were larger foundation sorts of relationships.
All right, always growing. Thank you, Pat, for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Now, if you'd like to learn more about volunteer opportunities with Books for Africa, head to KSDP.com and click on links. We'll be right back.